Hey everybody, it's AJ for Disney Food Blog, and today we are going to head over for another food tour in Walt Disney World. We are going to pop over to the Swan and Dolphin Resort. Now these are not owned by Walt Disney World, these are a Sheraton and a Westin, which means they are Starwood Resorts, which means they are Marriott Resorts, because everybody buys everybody else in this arena, and now they are Marriott Resorts. If you have a Marriott member number or anything like that, like I said, they were SPG or Starwood before, you could get discounts with that on these resorts, but you don't care about that. You care about the food, right? So let's head on over. These resorts are deluxe level resorts that are located right near Crescent Lake in Walt Disney World, which means they're right next to the Boardwalk Resort, the Yacht and Beach Club. They are within walking distance of the Hollywood Studios Park and Epcot as well. And of course, they have boat travel that goes to both locations too. So what's the difference between staying at Swan and Dolphin and staying at, say, Boardwalk or Yacht and Beach Club? Well, Swan and Dolphin's going to be significantly less expensive, especially if you can get a discount like a AAA discount. They have teacher discounts. They have several other discounts throughout the year as well. You do get access to fast pass booking and other amenities. You do not have a Magic Band, however, so you don't get a Magic Band to open your room. You will have just a regular room key to open your room, but you can, of course, get your own Magic Band in Walt Disney World to use for your ride bookings and things like that, or you can just use a Key to the World card as well still. So the Swan and Dolphin, especially now that Disney has introduced parking fees for people, because Swan and Dolphin always had parking fees and resort fees that sometimes brought it up, at nickel and dimed it and brought it up to almost the price of a Boardwalk or a Yacht Club, like with an annual pass holder discount. But now that Disney's introduced general parking fees as well for people staying at those resorts, the Swan and Dolphin is even a better deal to stay there. So definitely consider Swan and Dolphin if you're looking for a high-end deluxe level resort that's within walking distance of two parks. That's insane. It's just they're great options. They're really comfortable resorts, great food options here. And I just don't know. I think they're sleeper hits. Like, I don't know why people don't stay there more often, honestly, but maybe they do. I mean, it is kind of hard to get a room there, so maybe people have realized it. But anyway, keep them on your list of potentials. They are an incredible deal, I think, personally. Both of the resorts, the Swan and the Dolphin, are not Disney themed. They do have Disney stores in them, but they are not Disney themed. So that's important to know if you are going to Disney World with your family and you're looking for that kind of staying inside the magic all the time, and there's Mickeys in your room and things like that, like hidden Mickeys in your carpets and your wallpaper. You're not going to get that over there at the Swan and Dolphin. They are not Disney themed at all. So that's one important thing to note. The theming is very general. They have revamped many of the rooms in these hotels recently. They've revamped public areas in the Dolphin, and they are working on redoing the public areas in the Swan as well. So even though externally these look a little bit older with the color scheme, they have updated the rooms and they're updating the public areas. So they're very luxurious and they're very high end. So don't worry about that. Anyway, on to the food. Over at the Dolphin, you are going to find, we'll go smallest to largest, of course, like we usually do. So I'm going to start with Finn's, which is the lobby bar. Finn's, P-H-I-N-S, of course. This is the new lobby bar over there at the Dolphin that they just kind of unveiled a year ago or so. Here you get some appetizer portions of food, some great drinks, some really actually visually enticing drinks as well. There's the Smoke and Roses, which is really fun. It actually comes to your table in a smoke-filled box that they open up and all that smoke comes out. You get that smoky flavor sort of infused in the cocktail. I mean, it's really fun to Instagram that too, right? And they have the Proud Marys that are here usually only on Sundays. These are giant, unbelievable Bloody Marys that are huge. They are a meal in themselves. This has been a trend recently to have these sort of over-the-top cocktails, over-the-top sundaes. You've seen them, but these things are truly, truly giant. I think they're about $30 a pop though, so that is really going to be your meal. All right, moving on to Fuel. This is the grab-and-go location in the Dolphin Resort, and I love it. Here's why. Lots of great eats here, but they also have a Froyo, like, station, like a build-your-own Froyo, where they've got a bunch of different frozen yogurts every day. It changes out on a regular basis, but they have, like, peanut butter frozen yogurt, pineapple frozen yogurt, and all those great eats, all those great options to choose from. And then they have tons of toppings. Candy, boba, all kinds of stuff to put on your frozen yogurt. So if you are staying at the resort with kids, they will absolutely adore that. And even if you're not staying with kids, it's a lot of fun to stop at Fuel and grab your frozen yogurt. Anyway, lots of other options though at Fuel. There are hot sandwiches, the grab and go case, coffee bar. So lots of options here as well to just grab while you're running out or running to a meeting or heading into the parks. All right, next up, let's head over to the Cabana Bar and Beach Club. This is the pool bar, basically. But believe it or not, they had some great meals there as well. I was there last year and had an incredible meal where they're really playing around with a lot of good flavors and interesting flavors. They have a lot of aiolis on the menu, which I love aiolis. And so I tried all of them. I had like 7 sauces all lined up. But that's my jam. I think that's great. I'm a sauce person. I love trying new sauces. So the Cabana Bar and Beach Club is really good. They had a rosé back before they were even, you know, trendy, but it's a really great pool bar, probably one of the best in Disney World. Next up, there are 2 sort of mid-price range restaurants at the Dolphin. The first is a Fresh Mediterranean Market. This is where you're going to go for your breakfast meeting, basically. They have a breakfast buffet, create your own omelets, things like that. They have a dessert buffet as well, which is really, really good. Extensive dessert buffet. A la carte options, too. So this is your standard hotel restaurant to go get your, you know, your breakfast buffet or your breakfast before you head out into the parks. They also serve lunch and dinner, of course. It's going to be sandwiches, soup, things like that. It's definitely decent food, but it's not a destination location. The Fountain, however, is a destination location as far as I'm concerned. This is their ice cream restaurant. It's sort of a counterpart or competitor to Beaches and Cream across the lake over there at Beach Club Resort. So the Fountain is going to be like a diner. You're going to get burgers, hot dogs, chicken nuggets, salads, sandwiches, and things like that. But their ice cream menu is extensive. They have some great ice cream options, including awesome milkshakes, really, really killer milkshakes, including alcoholic milkshakes or spiked milkshakes. They have great sundaes. One of my favorites is the apple pie sundae, where there's a whole big, huge piece of apple pie in there, right there in the sundae. So lots of great options here. You definitely want to try out the Fountain if you are staying here, for sure. And maybe even if you're not staying here, the Fountain is a great option to try anyway. I think my only deterrent to the Fountain is that it's kind of out there in the middle of the lobby. It's not very themed. It could potentially be kind of loud because people are just sort of walking by all the time, sort of like a Kona Cafe feel, because you're kind of right out there in the middle of everything. That's my only real deterrent, is the theming versus Beaches and Cream, which is themed to the hilt. So those are my thoughts on the Fountain. Next, we're going to head over to Peekaboo. Peekaboo is a cafeteria, basically. They don't have cafeterias very often in these resorts anymore, but that's kind of what this is. So you're going to get your tray and sort of walk along a line and choose what you want to eat, or you can order some specifics from a menu. Peekaboo, oddly, is one of the 3 locations in Walt Disney World that's open 24 hours. So this one's open all night long, but of course the menu shrinks considerably in the middle of the night. But I will let you in on a little secret that I don't tell very many people. Peekaboo is my go-to for chicken wings, strangely, in the middle of the night. I think they serve them up until like 11 o'clock. So I will go over to Peekaboo and grab some chicken wings. They're really good. They're really good there. I don't know why. And their chicken wing, their buffalo sauce is so good there. So Peekaboo is kind of my dirty little secret that I always go and get chicken wings there, even though I've been eating all day. Oh, I'm so embarrassed, but that's what I totally do over there at Peekaboo. So they've got some decent eats, but this is sort of like, it's not a food court, but it's sort of like your food court option over there at the Dolphin. Oh, I'm embarrassed. Okay, next up, we're gonna head over to the signature restaurant. Shula's Steakhouse is, of course, a steakhouse. This is owned by Don Shula of Miami Dolphins fame, which you guys know from my steakhouse battle video that I don't want to like it, but I do, because I am a Bills fan, and so I, by law, have to hate the Miami Dolphins. But this is actually a pretty good steakhouse. So if you like the wood paneling, deep red leather version of steakhouse, this is the one to choose in Walt Disney World. They've got great options, huge steaks, massive desserts, big old sides, really good rich food. You're gonna be walking this one off for days, but it's excellent. And finally, we'll head over to Todd English's Blue Zoo. This is, of course, celebrity chef Todd English is putting his stamp on this menu over here. He's not in the kitchen most of the time, but he does pop in for the Swan and Dolphin Food and Wine Classic every year. This is going to be primarily seafood. The vibe in here is very Vegas-y. It's themed sort of to under the sea. You've got chandeliers that look like bubbles and things like that. Some of their most famous options are going to be seafood related. I do love the shrimp and grits here. I think it's excellent. Believe it or not, I had an awesome roasted chicken here the last time I was there. I never order chicken in signature restaurants, but it was really, really good. There's innovative appetizers, great desserts. Of course, the pastry chef is incredible here, Laurent Brenard, and he makes a great plate of chocolates for one of the desserts, which is just excellent and good to share as well. Another thing to note about Todd English is they do have a lounge here with a separate menu, which is usually pretty good as well. And the mixology here is really fun. They do a lot of really fun drinks, innovative stuff. It's kind of taken a little bit of a backseat in the past couple of years. They still have some great drink options on the menu from when they sort of revamped that cocktail menu previously. So definitely check out their mixology program here too. Okay, so heading on over to the Swan, we are going to start with Splash Terrace, and Splash Terrace is their pool bar here. Options here are going to be salads, lobster roll, burger, fish tacos, you know, your standard sort of American trendy menu is happening here. Of course, they've got lots of frozen drinks. They have a blood orange mimosa, pomegranate fizz. Pretty standard stuff, but still a good substantial meal is available here at Splash Terrace. Moving on to Kimono's, which is their sushi bar. This location is where you can actually do karaoke, of course. They have karaoke every night. They also have house-made sushi that's actually really, really good. So this is a good option for sushi if you're staying here or if you don't want to fight the battle of getting into one of the more popular sushi restaurants in a Disney park or in Disney Springs. Really good options here. And again, of course, karaoke. So, you know, if you're into that, this is where to go. Next up, we'll head to Garden Grove. This is a character location. You're not going to see Mickey here. You're going to see sort of secondary characters, Chip and Pluto. They have a breakfast buffet here. So if you are staying at the Swan or the Dolphin and you don't want to, like I said, fight the battle of going into a character meal at one of the other resorts or in the parks, this is a great option. It's also really inexpensive for a character meal. So definitely check that out. And finally, Il Mulino, which is the signature Italian restaurant over there at the Swan. This place is really good. The vibe is a little bit more adult-oriented, I think, as is the case with most of the restaurants, except for the character meal, of course, at these resorts. But it's still an excellent restaurant. Something I love particularly about Il Mulino is that they will allow you to order half portions. So if there are two pastas that you really want to try, you can order a half portion of both and try them both, which I think is really cool. This is honestly probably some of the better Italian food on property. Even though there seems to be an explosion of Italian food these days, this still holds up. This is still really excellent. All right, so those are your eats at the Swan and Dolphin. And don't forget, every year the Swan and Dolphin have the Food and Wine Classic. This year it's coming around Friday, October 26th and Saturday, October 27th. This is sort of a mini food and wine festival, and a lot of people who love the Food and Wine Festival never miss the Food and Wine Classic as well. Same sort of setup with food booths, lots of appetizer-sized portions, great options, lots of wineries represented, some killer desserts, and they also have seminars and demonstrations that you can sign up for. Something else that's fun about the Food and Wine Classic is that you can head over to several specialty food areas. They have a beer garden, they have a carnival corner, which is super fun, where they make corn dogs and funnel cakes and things like that. They have a Chinatown, which is really cool. They have incredible eats there every year. They have a bubble lounge that they just introduced last year, where they've got champagne, of course, and they also have a Sunday Bubbles brunch there as well on that Sunday. So lots of great eats at the Food and Wine Classic. Decent pricing too. So look into that if you're a fan of the Food and Wine Festival and are going to be there at the end of October. Definitely look into the Food and Wine Classic. We have all the information over on Disney Food Blog. So let us know what you guys think about Swan and Dolphin. Sometimes these resorts are forgotten. People don't realize that they're there or that they're so close to the parks. So let us know what you think. Have you stayed there? Did you like it? Did you think there were some improvements that could have been made? We'd love to hear from you in the comments. Thanks for listening and thanks for watching. Don't forget to check out the rest of our food tours. This is AJ from Disney Food Blog, and we'll see you real soon.